Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to More on Deck. In this video, I'm going to show you how to backup and sync files from your computer directly onto the Google Drive automatically. So for this, you'll need a small tool called Backup and Sync. I've been using this tool for almost 1 year and I found it really helpful and I thought to share it with you guys. So open up your browser and search for Backup and Sync. You should see this first link from Google. Just go to that link and you will see the download option. It's a very small tool, basically less than 2 megabytes. I have already downloaded the tool on my computer, so I won't be downloading it again. Once you have downloaded the tool, install and run it, and you should see this Google sign-in screen. So sign in with your Google account. Once you have successfully signed in with your Google account, you need to choose a folder on your computer that you would want to be backed up automatically to the Google Drive. You can see here I have a desktop, documents, and pictures. I don't want all of those to be backed up automatically, so I'm just unchecking these things. I want my custom folder stored on the desktop. You can see this syncing folder here. I want this folder to be automatically backed up, so I'll choose this folder here. Once I select this folder, you can see here I have it will validate the folder, and once it's validated, and down here we have an option for photos and videos, and we can choose in between whether we want to upload with a compressed size or with the original quality, and we can also choose to store our photos in Google Photos by picking this option. I'll just leave these things to default and hit next. And then we need to choose the folders on our Google Drive that we want to sync with the local drive, that means on our local computer. So make sure to check this icon, and by default it will be checked. And I don't want everything on my Google Drive to be synced automatically, so I'll just uncheck that. Currently you can see that I don't have anything on my Google Drive, so it's showing no folders in my drive, and I'll just check the second option here. So I'll just hit start and it will say that it will be merging with Google Drive content, so just click continue, and you'll see that a Google Drive folder is created on my desktop, and you can see down here below it is preparing to sync. These are some of my contents of my Google Drive folder that have been recently synced from the Google Drive, and it says updated just now, and you can also see that it is saying syncing 1 of 2. It is actually uploading my contents of synced folder to the Google Drive. You can see these are the contents, the same contents are being uploaded to my Google Drive. Show you these folders in my Google Drive. Actually, you can see this is my drive. This is the same folder as my drive on my desktop. I just put these two windows to side by side so you get a clear idea of what I'm talking about. So these two folders are the same, actually, one on the cloud and one on my computer. So any changes I make to these two, any of the folder, those will be reflected to another folder. My syncit folder on my desktop is same as in computers. My laptop and syncit is the same folder as on my desktop. Let's say I want to copy some folders from, I want to copy some files from my computer. Just copy these two files from my computer to the syncit folder. We should be able to see them. As well, and you can see down here it says uploading, so those files are uploaded. I'll just maximize this window here so you get a clear idea. Okay, you can see these two files have been uploaded to my drive in the Seekit folder. Let's say I remove these two files, so those are moved to trash. And when I go to my Seekit folder, it says those files were deleted, and would you like to delete them from your local folder as well? So that's one of the cool features from Backup Episode. Let's say I just remove them from my local computer as well. It says I deleted from my local computer. It's actually the activity that is being, that's happening around on our folders. And down here I'll just move these two files. Let's say I just move these two files to my iDrive folder on my desktop. I should be able to see the same files in my drive on the cloud. Go to my drive on the cloud. I'll just maximize this window. Okay, you can see here in my Seekit folder. Okay, there you go. You can see that files have been moved from Seekit folder to my folder. You can see these two files have been moved here. These two files. Okay, that's all from this video, guys. I hope this video helped you out. And if it did, then please share this video with someone you think would help them, because this will inspire me to make more such videos in the future. So thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.